What's up, guys? This is Putnin. Here to you coming through, and it's Napoleon to the war, dropping battle number 2. I play as United Netherlands. My opponent, SirMikeCoolStuff, plays as Denmark. And I'm gonna do this live for y'all. This was a request said by one of the people who commented in on my video. I forgot his name. I guess I'll figure it out later and type in who requested this in the video description under the video. Well, I was gonna rush across this bridge. I'm not the person to wait for other people to attack. It's really boring, and I really want to make vids that are very interesting to watch. I don't want to, you know, sit back and just fire back and forth at people. I want to see some blitzkrieg tactics. I want to see some good maneuvering and flanking attacks. I want to see some melee fights. People don't understand that you could shoot it out all day with your opponent. Well, not exactly all day, but you can shoot it out with your opponent for a good amount of time, but you'll run out of ammo eventually, and then you'll be stuck with melee. So how about you just go into melee with his troops once in a while, you know, just to save ammo, like I try to do sometimes. Like send my infantry to go into melee with just the rifles, or get his rifles distracted with mine, then send my infantry to go into melee with them, quickly finish them off, then shoot at his infantry units and send like my cavalry into melee with them. Pretty much use melee and firing at them, like use those in conjunction with each other. I mean, it's a great tactic to use, and it's very effective. Well, I was gonna rush across this bridge, but he had a good amount of his forces on the other flank, like in front of this little force of mine, and I didn't want to get overwhelmed and destroyed. So I was going to play it safe, sit back on this part of the flank, and I was going to start harassing his other flanks. I really do have a basic army. I have like 3 units of cav, 1 militia unit, 4-5 units of regular infantry, 2 grenadiers, 3 100 range, yeah, 300 one range, 100 range units, and 3 125 range units, a howitzer team, and a 12-pounder team, and 1 general staff. Yeah, I should have wrote that down. That would have been a lot more, informative, instead of just being so confusing. I said it all out of order and everything. Oh, screw it. I'm gonna write it down in the video description. Well, I set up my rifles. I skipped up a portion of the match of me just repositioning all my troops. I rushed up my riflemen. They were taking the free shots from his guys, so I quickly sent my heavy cav to deal some damage to his guys. So that's gonna get them disorganized, get them attacked from the front, and shot by my guys. So after that, I sent one of my heavy cav to go after his howitzer team that took out that. I routed one of his infantry units, and I'm about to route another, but now he quickly repositioned 3 of his infantry units to shoot my cav. I'm in a bad situation. And on this flank, the same cav that I sent to take out his howitzer team is being attacked by all his cav, so I'm in deep trouble. So I pretty much stirred up a hornet's nest. I'm being attacked everywhere now. On this flank, I'm trying to get outflanked by him, and I know I can't face these forces on my flank, so I have to back up a little so they won't get shot. And I'm shooting his guys from the flank a little bit. I have a reserve, 1 infantry unit in reserve, still inside the town just in case, so it's good to keep some reserves. And as you can see, I'm shooting the side of one of these units, so they look like they're about to rout soon. I'm trying to keep my distance with my riflemen. I mean, they do have the distance and the range advantage, so I just want to use that against them real quick, you know, deal some extra casualties instead of sustaining so much casualties trying to get closer. So it looks like he's taking some units out of that building. It looks like a church. I really don't know what it is. I mean, if that's a church, then that's like a hardcore church. I've never seen a church that big. Oh wait, no, yeah, I have. I've been to the Vatican. Never mind. I thought that was more of a hotel than a church. It's true. Alright, well, back to the match. It looks like he made like a little micro mistake here. He's rushing all his units to the other flank in front of my forces already positioned and taking free shots at him. But he got his units out of the building. They're just sharpshooters. His long riflemen, really. Got him out the building, going to melee with my militia units, and I sent my drone's bodyguard so I wouldn't lose this melee fight. So he's beating me on this flank. Has to reposition and combine forces with this flank. It looks like I won this flank for a miraculous reason. I don't know why. So he's going to run away his troops on this flank, so I'm going to run away my guys on this flank. He's routed a few of my units so far, and he routed the last protection these riflemen had, so I'm going to run at least one of them away. And I shouldn't have run this rifleman towards his cav. That's a very bad idea. So it looks like my howitzer team is trying to shoot his cav, which isn't exactly a large target for it to hit. So I'm going to start... I think I change its targets later on. I'm more worried about his infantry than his cav. I mean, they're so depleted. Yeah. I guess in dropping battles, every battle is on the unit scale small, so I guess so it won't lag or anything. It does make it very balanced and fair. I did have a 12-pounder, but he quickly killed it soon after. So it's slightly in my favor right now. I don't know why. I mean, he still has more units than me. Or at least I think he does. Nah, we have pretty much the same amount. I guess I have a couple more units than him, but they're very depleted. And they're not as good as his. All my... I have only... 5 units of infantry capable of attacking his units, and it looks like he still has a good amount, just 5. Still has some artillery, so take out his artillery. I'm gonna flank him from behind because there's a gap in those buildings that I can exploit to shoot him without them even noticing. And if he tries sending a force of infantry to attack that unit that I'm gonna send, then I'm gonna do a little rush down his center. So that's my strategy for this little stationary position he's in right now. And he has a couple units in this building, so I have to use my grenaders to take that building. And grenaders are great at melee, so it leaves me vulnerable to attack right now, and he should have used this to his advantage, because I sent about two grenaders and an infantry unit into that building to retake it, because I'm taking free shots from those guys in that building right now. Not very constant or accurate fire from now on in, but it's pretty much they're laying down a suppression fire to my troops, so if I try to go and attack his troops, and I'm gonna keep getting shot from behind with his guys in the building, then that's gonna ruin my morale. So I just wanted to take that building real quick, let him waste all his shots on that building instead of me wasting all my shots. So I figured, alright, let me take that building. That's a good strategic position. Also move up my rifleman and take some free shots at his guys, trying to kill as many of his infantry as possible. So I believe he does have the advantage right now, because the majority of my infantry are in that building trying to take it. So if he did a simple infantry rush on this flank, doesn't matter which flank, they both have one infantry protecting their rifle, so it doesn't matter which flank, he could have just done a simple infantry rush or a concentration of forces on one flank, and he would have most likely turned it. So I've taken this building successfully, and he's wasting all his shots on that building. And I've taken out his artillery. I must have ninja'd them, because he didn't even react. He finally sees my infantry behind his forces. And since he's going to target them instead, I'm going to start pushing up on this flank. He's going to try and go into melee with them. That's sweet, because I wanted to... It was getting very boring. So either way, I'm going to go into melee like I said I was for... If I know I'm gonna win these matches, then I'll go into melee with him. See, GG right here. He knows he lost and all, so... So I'm gonna go into melee with his guys, you know, make a little action-filled ending instead of just shooting it out ending, which is very boring. So let's go duke it out with his troops. I would shout Leroy Jenkins, but my mouth is right here by the mic, so I don't want to burst anybody's eardrums. I'll do it one day, don't worry. Don't worry, I'm capable of doing it. So I'm going to melee with his guys over here. They're going to get hit from behind and the front. And his guys run away in fear before I get into melee with them right here, so very unfortunate. But right here, he's saying that I can't manage to pull off a win, and all. I just was like, GG. It's not my problem. Well, good game to my opponent, SirMikeCoolStuff.